Guys, bring it in.
Listen, if you're banged up, that's the only way we're going to make adjustments. Otherwise, it's going to be the 11 playing 45, then the next 11 playing 45. But if you're hurt, let me know so we can adjust. With that being said, let's keep the ball. Three in the middle. All have to defend, all have to attack, but stay in the shape. And let's communicate, and let's make it easy for me so I don't have to do much talking, and I can evaluate. Got it?
45 minutes, let's just go hard.
Go hard for 45? Yeah,
we pressure, smart. We pressure high, but smart.
Yeah. But smart.
We leave everything on the field, all right? Let's go start.
Hey, it's windy, let's keep it low. Let's go. Let's keep it.
Size on three, fellas. One, two, three, start!
The last time Detroiters endured such a cold and snowy winter, the University of Michigan had just begun playing football. That was more than 130 winters ago.
It is the coldest it has been in decades.
It's a cold hell, if you can imagine.
Every 30 seconds I have, oh, it's really cold out.
This week, the American media has been having a frenzy over a new term, the polar vortex.
More frightening than your worst nightmare. This, the most important mainstream news story for days on end.
It's now late March, and with spring lurking just around the corner, some of the players take advantage of the first sunny day of the season.
Outside the box, Adam. It's been so long, 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 long.
How about Manchester United today, man?
Hey, I want them to win.
Yeah, me too.
Because then they'll play, I don't want to put Barcelona to play Bayern Munich.
Barca is the one first.
Huh?
Barca has to beat, I thought to go first.
They're going
to
win.
During the winter, the players train at Total Soccer, an indoor training facility in the city of Wixom. Every Tuesday and Wednesday, players come to tryouts, hoping to make a good impression and receive a spot in the final roster for the upcoming season.
We've gone from 80 plus players down to a pool of about 40 to 45 guys that we're currently looking at to be a part of the Michigan Stars Football Club. With that, we are going to make our reserve team as well as our top team. They're going to be training together, and best 18 will dress.
From that side, 5v5 plus two.
And we're just going to do possession game. There's no points, just keep possession of the ball. We're going to minimize the touches eventually from unlimited two touch to one touch. It's a tight area, 10 people plus a neutral in this little area, but I want us to play quick. We got to learn to play quick. That's how I want to play, that's how we're going to play. Well, let's be smart about it, it's a limited touch to start. Play small-sided, 8v8 this way, 8v8 that way.
Everyone's going to get a lot of touches today, and let's have some fun.
Got it? We have a group of guys that can play at a very high level. Now the question is, can they play in my system? I'm the type of guy who is going to put high pressure, win it back, we're going to keep the ball, keep it on the ground.
Go run it, create a space, get in an angle. It needs to be better. This isn't good enough. It needs to be better. Everybody, play smart. Communicate more positively. Please, play.
We have our first official friendly at the end of the week. Building up to that, we've trained twice a week for probably the last month and a half, focusing on this friendly.
Coach Nate and I, we meet up every morning, Tuesdays and Wednesdays, and we go over our training for that day. We go over our player pool, we go over the specific session.
Ryan M. Right middle.
Edwin.
Next team, Kyle.
Kevin Pinkos.
Mario
Rowe.
Eli,
up top right.
When we do the 5v5 with the bumpers, one field will have a neutral. So it'll be 5v5 plus one and bumpers.
Okay.
Very exciting day today with the Michigan Stars Football Club. We have Ben Myers coming in from Michigan State University.
So he can get
I'm just skipping class right now.
Yeah, he needs to absolutely get something done so he can stay, because I don't know.
Unfortunately, I couldn't make it this weekend. I had to go out of town for a soccer tournament, like youth. But Nate called me, and he was very, I could tell on the phone, he was very excited with what he saw. Very excited with you. I understand you were out of position.
You had to play center back for 60 minutes.
And never played it before.
Never.
And he said you were solid.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I know that position pretty well since I play holding mid.
Sure. So. And that's what we were saying. I mean, a good player can adapt.
This year, we're going to have a mix of current college players, former college players, former professional players.
A lot of our players have aspirations of playing at the professional level, and that's one thing that Coach Sam and myself are here to do, is to provide them with the environment and the routes and tools needed.
Salvatore Piraine highlights the crucial roles that members of his backroom team play during the preseason.
The guys I brought in for a reason. I sat with them individually and told them my philosophy and my style, and they all agreed or are willing to adjust to it. They all know their roles, their responsibilities.
We'll just go the width of 18 since we're not going to 4v3.
Right. Yeah, you guys got two going.
Our first official friendly against the U of M club team. It's a fundraising event for Fraser High School. We're putting together this event so I can take a good look at the guys playing against not only themselves but against another team now. We have 22 guys dressing for the game. I have two even 11v11 teams playing. They're each going to play 45 minutes, and with that I'm just going to see how the guys pair up together. I have a big group and anyone can play, but the pairings I'm putting together is something that I have ideas for, and I'm looking to see how it works.
Oh, there's no power anywhere, look. Even the gas station doesn't have power. Their thing's not working either.
Really?
I wonder what's going on.
Number 8, Harun.
Yeah. What number is he normal?
So 6.
Oh. Is he going to get pissed?
Why is the number 6 so important to you?
I've been playing with it since freshman in high school, so I just stuck with him.
Yeah, Hader told Sammy at the game, like, oh, don't take it away from Harun.
Yeah, he tried to give it to someone else. We weren't having it, so got it back. But yeah, I've been playing with it for over 10 years now, man, so I just stick with it, you know?
Let's take this game as serious as possible. This is a trial for some. I'm finishing rosters here in the near future, and we're not completely full.
So you're gonna get a 45-minute game in today, and then the second group that's playing the second half, we're gonna do some fitness throughout the first half, and then the group that played the first 45, afterwards you're gonna do some stuff on the sideline just to stay fit. This is a preseason event for me and for you, and that's all I'm treating you. All right, so just one. Ball and dogs do work, and then we'll adjust anything we need to adjust as the game goes on.
First preseason friendly of the 2014 campaign took place on Sunday, the 30th of March, with the Stars winning the game 6-2 against the University of Michigan club team. A lot of this is uncharted territory, uncommon ground, parts unknown. If the next season will say a lot about the Michigan Stars' future ambition, then the next few months will say a lot about their direction in general as they prepare for the beginning of a new journey.